Archaeologists in Tibet have discovered the oldest settlement of the Stone Age. In Slovakia, the remains of a man with a wolf's mouth were found, and in Mexico, the Tower of Skulls. Why did all the rulers try to dismantle the pyramids of Giza? Watch this video and more. Hi friend, you're on the KirTop channel. Ancient settlement destroyed by the tsunami. Scientists have discovered traces of a powerful earthquake and tsunami that destroyed the settlements on the Chilean coast 3,800 years ago. People who lived on the coast of the Chilean Atacama Desert 4,000 years ago built villages from small stone houses on shell foundations. These houses stood not far from each other with access to the courtyards, and the dead were buried under their floors. The floor and walls were held together with a mortar of seaweed ash, seawater, and shells. Diego Salazar of the University of Chile and his colleagues explored these settlements and found large-scale destruction in them. For example, at one of the destroyed houses, the stones were carried away from the sea, as if knocked out by a giant wave. In another, the building material, on the contrary, is scattered towards the sea. Most likely, it was dragged by the water flowing into the sea. In another settlement, archaeologists found layers of sand and earth interspersed with many shells. Radiocarbon analysis showed that there are old shells in the layer of relatively new shells, as if a wave pulled them out of the ground and mixed them up. After analyzing the destruction, scientists came to the conclusion that 3,800 years ago, there was a powerful tsunami, a wave from which destroyed settlements and caused upheavals in society. The reconstruction showed that the earthquake was caused by a giant thrust and subduction contact between the South American tectonic plate and the Nazca plate. The seismic moment of the earthquake should have reached 9.5 points, which somewhat exceeds the most powerful Chilean earthquake of 2010. Rare Bone Cross. The director of the Rostov Kremlin State Museum Reserve, Alexander Filaev, announced an interesting find by archaeologists. A rare bone cross was found measuring 6 by 3.5 by 0.9 centimeters. The front side depicts the Theotokos and John the Evangelist, and the reverse side depicts the saint in full growth. The inscription on the cross is illegible and probably reads Nickel. It is believed that this is an image of Saint Nicholas. Research in the Metropolitan Mansions goes in parallel with large-scale restoration work at the site. Excavations are carried out by the archaeological sector of the museum. According to preliminary data, the found cross belonged to the 16th century. It was found in layers that have formed before the 50s-60s of the 17th century, before the construction of the building. Ocher, tools, and drugs trade. Scientists have discovered quarries built 2,100 years ago. They were part of the huge trading system of the indigenous people of Australia, Mitaka. It was called the Australian Silk Road. Australian indigenous people lived in the heart of a huge trade route, which is compared in volume to the Silk Road. Archaeologists have found sandstone mining sites in Australia on an industrial scale. They are, as far as researchers know, the largest in the Southern Hemisphere. This means that the trading systems of the first people of Australia were at the world level. These territories were called the Country of the Channels because of the interweaving of streams that were filled with water from the monsoon rains. Archaeologists were able to find out that the quarries of the Mitaka people who lived here were part of a well-developed trading system. Grinding stones, silicate tools, seeds, and much more were produced there. Grinding stones mined and processed on the land of the Mitaka people were exchanged for ochre, wooden objects, stone axes, and pituri, that is a drug. Mitaka land was once the center of a vast transcontinental trade route that traded from the Gulf of Carpentaria in the north to the Flinders Ranges in South Australia. Mitaka Indigenous Corporation Director Tracy Howe said that facilities were proof they had a truly developed economy. Ancient Roman city and the longest white road. The use of radar technology during archaeological research has been practiced for more than once a year, but it was in 2020 that it most successfully proved its worth. Not far from Rome, researchers using georadar found the ancient Roman city of Fallary Novi. And this despite the fact that until that moment it was already considered well studied. In fact, Phalerae Novae began to be explored as early as the 19th century, but until recently there were no resources for large-scale excavations. It was a geodetic radar survey that made it possible to discover the architectural complexes of the city previously unknown to archaeologists. Frames, an amphitheater, a bath complex, and others. Another discovery made last year using radar is the longest wide road. It is located in Central America on the Yucatan Peninsula. Archaeologists suggest that the age of the road is about 1,000 years, and its construction was the initiative of the queen of the Mayan tribe Kavil Ahab. Stone Age settlements in Tibet. A number of Stone Age settlements have been discovered by scientists in recent years in Tibet. Their research served as an important breakthrough for the archaeological periodization of the history of mankind in the territory of the Tibet Autonomous Region. During 2020-2021, a group of archaeologists explored the settlement of Mapotso in the Kanmar district of Shigatse City. During the excavations, 10 burials, ash pits were found, the age of which is about 4,000 years. The finds include items made of stone, ceramics, and bones, as well as jewelry made of shells, jade, etc. Mapotso is the most ancient settlement among the known settlements in the deep regions of the Tibetan Plateau. Judging by the finds, ancient people were engaged in fishing and hunting here. The discovery will provide new opportunities in the search for answers to questions related to the culture of the late Paleolithic in Tibet and human adaptation to the highlands. In 2021, archaeologists also unearthed 14 ancient tombs in Bembar County, Chemdo City, and unearthed 40 artifacts including pottery, bronze, turquoise, and bowl-shaped ornaments. Chen Zuyun, a senior researcher at the Tibetan Institute for the Preservation of Cultural Monuments, said that the chronology of the finds, based on the radiocarbon dating data, refers to two periods, about 1,800 and 1,100 years ago. In 2021, the cultural departments of Tibet launched 21 archaeological projects and conducted research on 277 cave temples, as well as completed work on the preliminary examination of the possible impact of 12 major infrastructure projects on the protection of cultural heritage sites. The remains of a guy with a wolf's mouth. Archaeologists have discovered in Slovakia the remains of two individuals who were buried in the 17th or 18th century in a storage pit and in a hastily dug grave. One of them belonged to a young man who had orofacial clefts, a cleft palate, and a cleft lip. According to scientists, their death could have been violent since people with similar vices in some societies were considered vampires. Today, one of the most common craniofacial malformations in orofacial clefts, which occur approximately 1.4 times per thousand newborns. Doctors distinguish three main forms of this congenital defect. Cleft lip, lip and palate, or only the palate. In colloquial speech, the concepts of cleft lip and cleft palate are used to describe such pathologies. Both genetic and environmental factors are involved in the pathogenesis of this disease. Although orofacial clefts are common today, human remains with such malformations are rare in the archaeological context. The most famous exception is the pharaoh Tutankhamun, whose tomb was discovered in the Valley of the Kings in 1922. In addition to the cleft palate, paleopathologists diagnosed him with clubfoot, Kula's disease, and several other diseases and injuries. In total, archaeologists know about 50 such examples, and in 80% of the cases, orofacial clefts were found in adults. So, the remains of one of the individuals were found in Altai during excavations of the burial of the Andronova culture in the burial ground of Fursuwa the 14th. He was a young male, aged 1823, who died around 1883-1665 BC. Scientists noted that the remains of a young man with a cleft lip and cleft palate were found on the territory of Slovakia for the first time in an archaeological context. Archaeologists reported that in modern population, this pathology is much more common. Perhaps this is due to the fact that in the past there was a high mortality of children with orofacial clefts. They were infanticides. In addition, maternal diet may have reduced the incidence of this malformation. The researchers concluded that both of these people could be foreigners. It seems that the body of a young man was lowered into the pit with his feet down, and perhaps he was previously tied up. An adult man was lowered with his head or back down. The bricks present in the backfill, according to archaeologists, could be due to the fact that the buried were considered dangerous dead. Although the scientists did not find any traumatic injuries, they did not rule out a violent death, but perhaps they could be from illness, hypothermia, or from some other reason. Tower of Skulls in Mexico. In fairness, it should be clarified that the very phenomena of the Tower of Skulls is not something new and unique. However, it was 2020 that gave archaeologists the opportunity to discover another such object. We found a new tower not far from the previously explored one on the territory of the Templo Mayor temple complex, which is located near Mexico City. The diameter of the Tower of Skulls is almost 5 meters, and the remains of more than 100 people have already been found in it. Archaeologists defined the date of creation of this object as the end of the 15th century. The Mexican government has already reacted to the discovery. The Minister of Culture of Mexico, Alejandro Frausto, called the found object the most impressive archaeological find in the country in recent years. The earliest fragments of the Mayan calendar. Two fragments of an ancient wall may contain the earliest evidence of a preliterate Mayan calendar. These images include, in particular, the head of a deer decorated with a dot and a line on top, which is one of the dates of the 260-day calendar cycle. These fragments were found in a temple built 2,200 years ago on the territory of modern Guatemala in Central America. A number of ancient civilizations in the pre-Columbian Americas, including the Aztecs, Maya, Mixtecs, and Zapotecs, tracked time using 13-day cycles marked with numbers, along with 20-day cycles associated with the gods. In such a calendar, each day was assigned both a number and a reference to a deity, which gave 260 unique combinations before the whole cycle was repeated. It is believed that the Indians used their calendar to determine the moments of the most important ceremonies and also marked historical dates in it and tried to predict future events with its help. Until now, the earliest evidence of the use of the calendar by ancient people came across on stone monuments dating from about 100 BC. Now, David Stewart of the University of Texas at Austin and his colleagues have found evidence that the Maya may have used this calendar a century earlier. Previously, back in 2001, this group excavated in the area of the archaeological complex of San Bartolo, which includes the Las Pinturas Pyramid, which means paintings. During the excavations, it turned out that the Mayans, who inhabited the city, repeatedly rebuilt the buildings, demolishing the old buildings and using them, in particular, in order to lay the foundation of the pyramid. Analyzing pieces of gypsum taken from the base of the pyramid, scientists discovered two fragments that fit perfectly together, which formed the symbol of the corresponding date. The oldest malt in Britain. The remains of a Roman malt house and charred spelt were found during excavations in Bedfordshire before the start of roadworks on the A428. Experts analyzed the find and suggested that the people who lived in the area were making beer. The site known as Field 44 was excavated from July 2021 to February 2022. During excavations, teams from the London Archaeological Museum and the Cambridge Archaeological Unit unearthed the remains of buildings from the Iron Age or late Roman period. The Iron Age in Britain lasted from about 800 BC before the arrival of the Romans. Scientists were able to establish that the charred spelt grains found were left to germinate before drying in an oven. This was probably done for the production of malt. Special brewing equipment could not be found at the excavation site, so it is not known where the ancient people completed the brewing of beer. Richard Ballantyne, the project's scientific advisor, believes that there were malt houses on the territory of Field 44, and the raw materials were transported to another area. It also means that different communities in Britain were in close contact with each other. In 2019, evidence of ancient brewing was found during road repairs on the A14 in Cambridgeshire. Then the remains of ancient beer, bread, and porridge were found. Scientists have established that beer was made from barley, oats, and wholemeal flour, adding herbs. Why did they try to dismantle the pyramids of Giza? The Egyptian pyramids have been considered a wonder of the world for more than a century, striking the imagination of each new generation. But not everyone knows that because of the greed of the rulers of Egypt, we have more than once risked losing them forever. 12th century, by our standards, deep antiquity. But then the pyramids of Giza were as ancient as they are today. However, the young Sultan of Egypt, Al-Aziz Osman, did not appreciate antiquities too much and therefore decided to demolish them. Historians do not know exactly what motivated him. Some say that he believed that treasures were buried under the pyramid of Menkaure, not only inside its chambers, but also under the foundation of the structure. Others say he wanted to destroy the pyramid so he could use the stone to build a new city wall. This seems like a plausible explanation, as other Egyptian leaders demolished smaller pyramids to get stone for construction. Al-Aziz did not seem to care much about the historical significance of the pyramids. Moreover, he did not even know about it. He knew that they were old, but people at that time did not know who built the pyramids and why. In some historical periods, people did not know at all that these were the tombs of kings, believing that they might have been ancient granaries. The Sultan ordered his men to proceed with the demolition of the Menkaure pyramid. However, things didn't work out. Historians have repeatedly described how incredibly difficult it was to build such large buildings without modern equipment. As it turned out, destroying such structures without modern technology is not easier. The workers managed to loosen several huge blocks, which fell into the desert sand and probably flattened several assembled onlookers. But it was such a slow process that Al-Aziz eventually withdrew the workers. The opening, which they managed to dismantle, exists to this day. This was not the last time someone tried to take apart the pyramids. Modern Egypt began in the 19th century under the rule of Muhammad Ali Pasha, who wanted to take apart the pyramids and use the rubble to build a dam and block the Nile. He reasoned that he would get rid of the old and give it a new life, putting it in the service of modern technology. As the story goes, the rescue of the pyramids fell to the chief French engineer, Linen Pasha. Linen volunteered to head a commission studying the costs of the project, and through some ingenious calculations, he convinced the Sultan that he could have a lot of money simply by extracting the stone needed for construction from a quarry. Linen himself told the story many times, however, constantly changing some important facts, for example, confusing the name of the Sultan at whose court he served. It is possible that Linen's participation was his fantasy, and the Egyptian engineers themselves came to the conclusion that this is easier to extract stone in an ordinary quarry. After all, crushed stone is cheap, and dismantling the pyramid is the opposite. Rate this video with your thumbs up or down and share it with your friends. Leave your kind comments to help in the development of the channel. Thanks for your views. Bye, everyone!